Today's game is coming to you live from Croakland, Crazed Zonia, at the infamous Hellhole Coliseum, where if the smog doesn't kill you, the fans sure will. Today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams take the field. The Atlanta Vultures take on the Croakland Invaders. Have won the alien flip and can choose to kick off or receive. They choose to receive. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hi again, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with the only guy to ever get cut from the league for testing positive for not taking enough steroids or mutant growth hormones, Brickhead Mulligan.
Hey, there was a reason for that. I had to quit taking steroids. My nutsack was shrinking, and I sprouted this mini-me on my shoulder. Pricks Jr., freak me out.
You're a pussy.
The defense goes for the jugular and rushes.
You know, in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the MFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about.
And it's first and 10. Doesn't like what he sees, so he's calling an audible.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and 2. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
First and 8 to go. They're going for 2 here. And they run it in for 2 points. And they take their first time out here. The quarterback apparently needs a few more seconds to explain. Put the ball in the end zone to the slower players. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And that's why they call it the money shot. Oh, that'll trim your nostril hairs once and for all. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Well, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico, but rather to crack their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down in a very lot. The defense just called an audible, and the QB is praying it's not a dirty trick. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. down and long.
Hot, hot one, hot two.
Well, that was a good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
And they'll line up for the punt here. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade, Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And it's first and ten. And he rumbles for nine on that play. Bring up second and one. Third and two.
Typical quarterback, caught an audible because he thinks he's so much smarter than his coach.
I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game. For a couple of yards. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And that'll be second and eight to go. About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Third down and three. The QB keeps the defense guessing by calling an audible at the line.
Man, he really wants it.
First down. And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
Yeah, telling me. Nice run.
No, I mean, he's a real stud. He works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers. And it's first and ten. East Roid Rage ignites that deep. There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
First and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And the QB might as well just bury him. A great throw and a great catch, but sadly to the wrong team. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely.
first and 10. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second down and 10. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it. Second down and a lot. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Third down and the punter is warming up. The quarterback changes the play.
He's so indecisive.
He's not going down. And he breaks away. This guy's a brick shithead. And Mencats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And that'll be their final timeout. And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. The defender says, I don't think so. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. And it's the NFL Halftime Show. Hey, Bricks, lots of families in the house tonight. This is fun for the whole family.
Yeah, what 10-year-old hasn't dreamt about being locked in a cage with zombie refs?
You have two goals, kill zombies and live, and run. Well, I guess that's three goals, really. And that's one of the scariest sounds in the NFL. Why in the NFL, no one leaves their seats at halftime.
What was that song? So close, yet so far.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
His
mom decided to move back in with us.
Second down and 2.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
And that'll bring up third and 1. You can tell he's a berserker because he's from it. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Now, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. fumble. You've got to protect the ball better than that. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. A mix of tiger blood, shark blood, and internet comments, roid rage brings out the worst in anyone. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big ball.
The defense comes up big, stopping a two-point attempt. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
I don't know if he even had a target on that throw.
Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
One time when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Third down and, well, good luck.
He's lucky.
That guy's so fast he can strike lightning twice.
He could go all the way.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
And it's first and ten. He is fighting for...
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all, Grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Second down and nine. And he punched his way out of it, and the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his...
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. First and ten. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second down and long.
Hot one, hot two.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here.
First and eight to go. Second down and nine. Not sure who he was throwing to on that play. Third down and nine.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's devastating hit, knocks the ball loose. Man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. It's a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, and the defense jumps on sides and it's... Oh, wow. If you're a defender, the only good QB is a dead one, Bricks.
Oh, he must be pretty good then, because he is dead.
The offense is losing quarterbacks faster than teams lose their minds at spring break. They're down to their last QB before they have to forfeit. And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up five on that play. Second down and five. And he's running like a moose, and he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that'll bring up third and one. Crusher right there, folks. And the two-minute warning sound.
Sounds like what, Grim?
Sounds like the asshole I'm living on.
And they'll line up for the punt here. And he put all of his foot into that one. First and 10. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
Second down and more than the QB would like.
One, hot two.
I'm surprised no one uses the electric carving knife anymore, Brick.
There with ours. That was the first time I lost my ear. The ear fairy gave me a quarter point, though.
The timeout is called by the cornerback. They have one left. Third down, and the punter is warming up.
Missing was his number for the last three plays. Talk about luck.
In a hurry up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench.
I know I've said never hit a man when he's down. It's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
That's it. That's the last time out. It's score or die from here out. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't...
They just called an audible on defense. Offense hopes it's not a dirty trick.
And he was stuck to him like glue.
The offense goes into their 2 minutes. It's hard for the D to call an audible before the offense snaps the ball. They got that off in time. He picks up 8 yards on that pass. The defense looks hungry out there.
They just called an audible on defense. Offense hopes it's not a dirty trick.
That play had no chance. This baby is over and the fat lady is singing.
Speaking of fat, once I decide to burn some calories, so I set a fat kid on fire.
Hey, I wonder if a fat drug dealer sells diet.
And it's first and 10.
It's a zap attack.
Devastating hit knocks the ball loose. Got crushed. When in a hurry-up offense, the defense calls an audible.
Well, maybe they're rehearsing for a musical. You never know, Grim. You never know.
That ball was almost intercepted. The Croakland Invaders take the loss today.
And that quarterback took one in the ass, too.
Battled hard, but still got their butts handed to them.
Gross. I hope there weren't any orc butts involved.
I kind of like orc butts, especially with some Dijon mustard and a smoked pickle relish. And the bat's living.
Let's go down to the field and see what the game's MVP thinks of today's outcome. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you can fill it.